Okay, what I'm going to do now is try and demonstrate what the B delay is all about and the A intensified with B function on this. And we have dual time bases, and what does that mean to us? And at the moment, what I've got hooked up here is the output from a videotape player, and I'm looking at a videotape. And right now I'm locked into the 60 hertz frequency, and I see that every 60 times a second I blank the screen and do something, and then I trace it again. Well, that's my vertical, is what I believe it is. I'm going to first of all disclaim my knowledge of television. I'm pretty weak in it, didn't do this as a job or anything, but so I'm kind of just speaking what I believe is going on here, and if you find me wrong, well, good for you. But in the meantime, let's go ahead with this. 60 times a second, I'm painting the vertical on the screen. I'm going to trace across the screen so many times and make one complete screen, and then I'll make another complete screen and so on. So I'm looking at that right now. Now if I turn my frequency up and start to look at what happens in between, I'm going to see that there's some repetition that goes on there too. There we go. It's at a whole another frequency, so. It's interesting to know that in the vertical trace I have a whole lot of additional blanking and tracing going on. So what's this all about? Well, what this I think is this is my lines across the screen with the chroma data, the luminance and chroma, the color and the brightness of the signal as it goes across the screen. So in between each one of these is one line trace across the TV. And then as the intensity of the light and the colors change, I'm going to see the signals in between change brightness and intensity. And that's what's going on in my line. But now, what if I'd like to say, gee, I would really like to kind of take a look at what's going on in this region. I could turn up my frequency thing, time base this way, and try and trigger in on it. Maybe it's not easy to do. I'm trying to zoom in on this region to the left, but it's not letting me do it. So how about I go back? Okay, display that repetitive signal image, and now I go to what they call A intensified by B. That's this. If I count from the bottom up on the horizontal, I go with the second one, push that in. I'm gonna adjust my intensity a little bit here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my time base knob, and I'm going to pull it out, and I'm going to rotate it clockwise. And what I'm doing is I'm adjusting my B time base. I'm raising my B time base to a time that's higher than my A. I'm going to leave the A where it was. But when I did that, with A intensified by B, I see the A signal back there all right, but I see where there's a bright patch right in here. And maybe I'm killing my... All right. My video here. I'm hoping you can see this okay without being blinded by it, but I can move by adjusting my time delay using my knob up here. I can move where that brightness sits over my A channel waveform, my A time base waveform. And what I'm doing is I'm saying, gee, I would kind of like to examine this region right here. So I'm centering it on that, and I'm going to now push my B delayed. Lo and behold, it took that bright area and expanded it, and it shows me what it looks like. I'll turn it up just a little bit here, maybe. I don't know, maybe not. Let's try that. I think you can see that. I can see it okay on the camera side back here. And then we go back to A intensified by B. Here's A by itself. A intensified by B. I can shift where B is going to look. And then I go to B. And I see what it looks like. So it zoomed in on that area where I was interested in taking a look at the signal. There's a whole lot of other capabilities this thing has. I mean, I got low frequency rejection capability, high frequency rejection. I can trigger off of channel one or two, and I can adjust the trigger for my B delayed if I want. Like I'm doing that right now. Or I can go back and use the trigger off of A down here to sync myself in. So a lot of sophisticated capability here. And when you want to try to zoom in on some strange area of a complex waveform and see what's going on, it's nice to have that capability. So yeah, that's what I wanted to get it across to you. It is functioning. It's functioning well. It is a nice capability. This is a sophisticated scope, so wanted to get that across. Thanks for watching. Well, okay, we're not going to just give you this beautiful scope. Although it by itself would be certainly worth the price, and it would make a marvelous addition to any bench. But we're going to also include a set of brand new 100 megahertz probes to go along with it. These are the type that have the grabbers on the end, or you can pull those off and have the needles. And we're going to also give a Tektronix scope manual. This is an original manual. This manual in itself is worth $52, roughly. It has the fold-out prints in it, all of your voltage conditions, test conditions, everything. So, you absolutely will have top-notch quality reference material to go along with this scope. Instruction manual, prints, service information, the whole shot. So how can you go wrong, you know? You've really, it's a beauty. So, happy bidding. Good luck to you. Thanks for listening.